Would you like to enter things in QuickBooks Online as simple as it was in the good old days? Well, in that case, you could always use the QuickBooks Online Register window. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. Account registers are an alternative place to enter some transactions. It's a way of entering a transaction directly into the account that will be affected by that transaction. Every account in the chart of accounts, except an income and expense type of account, can be opened in a register window. However, I should warn you that you cannot enter every possible type of transaction into the register. For transactions that you can enter, registers do not always allow the details that you need to record. And if this happens, you must enter the transaction in the windows that we already learned about in this or the prior course. So why would anyone use registers? Well, old-fashioned bookkeepers like to record bank and credit card transactions in a window that resembles the old-style register books for bank and credit card accounts. As you record a transaction, you can see the prior transactions as well as the balance of the account as it changes when you enter the new transaction. It shows the running balance, the balance after each transaction. It's the only window that can mark a transaction as cleared before or after doing bank reconciliation. Now that last point is something I strongly recommend against, and we'll circle back to that at the end of this video. But that is the only unique thing about registers. Anything else you can enter in the register, you can enter in the normal window that you would normally use to record the transaction. Let's enter some example transactions. So, let's imagine on May 14th, we gave check number 901 to Reese's Repair Ranch for fixing our equipment, and the amount was $300. Well, that's very simple. All we have to do, let's make this a little taller here. All we have to do is scroll down to where it says accounting and open the chart of accounts. Since this transaction affects this account, our bank account, we can click View Register. Now this is what the register window looks like, and if you choose the bank account for View Register, you'll get only assets that you know, a limited number of accounts that you can choose, and you could change accounts just from this pull down. You don't have to go back to the previous window. But we're recording this in the cash and bank. Now notice it shows payment and deposit, and if the scroll were working correctly, what you would see is the running balance. I'll see if I can fit it into the screen. The running balance. So you see here are some prior transactions that we recorded in the bank account. These are decreases to the bank account, and you can see the running balance going down. And then of course this deposit from Betty back on May 8th is an increase to the bank account, and you can see the balance went up. So you can see all the transactions in this particular account and see the running balance in the same window that you can record a new transaction. Now this transaction is a check. So if I click check, the register window will give me just the fields I need to write a check. Now this is check 901, and we're writing the check to Reese's Repair Shop. So we have to click this way. So the payee is Reese's Repair Ranch. Remember the date was back in May, I think it's May 14th of 2017. be careful, because when you work with computers nowadays, the year is relevant. Now, the account is repair expense, just like it would be if we recorded it in the normal write a checks window. And of course, the payment amount is $300. So we've recorded all the information and we might want to add a memo. Now look what happens when we click save. Look what happens to the balance. We click save. And of course, after we save it, we can click, go back and click cancel to close the interface. And you can see that, well, I guess it recorded it here. But you can see that if you change the order of the, you change the order here. Well, oh, actually, it's the order is the earliest back in January, all the way up to the latest. So you can see that it really decreased by 300 when it came from the transaction on the 9th to the transaction on the 14th. So let's try the next one. What's this one? May 15th charged UPS $100 from the Capital One credit card for a delivery today. Well, that should be easy. Change registers to the credit card register. And then, of course, all you have to do is put in the date. You know, you click add credit card expense. Boom. And now the payee was UPS for a delivery in the amount of $100. So now this was May 15th, and you charged UPS. Okay, just don't worry. Nope, don't change it to bill payment, because this transaction is separate from previous bills. The expense, just like normal, is delivery expense, and the charge was for $100. And now you'll see the balance of the credit card account go up to $2,100 as of May 15th. I click save, and now you can see the balance is $2,100 as of May 15th. You can click cancel to remove the interface and go back to the register window itself. Now, if we open these transactions from the trial balance, the way we've been doing all along, these transactions would look exactly the same as the ones that were recorded in different windows. For example, repair expense, if I double click and I scroll to the bottom of repair expense, you can see this check on May 14th, check 901, Teresa's Repair Ranch, increased our repair expense by $300, just like any other check. And if we go back to the trial balance and we open up delivery expense, double click the number, we scroll to the bottom, we see that this May 15th charge to delivery is like any other credit card charge from an expense from the Capital One credit card for delivery expense, and this increased our delivery expense by $100. And of course, if you opened up the Capital One credit card or the bank account, it would look just like the previous charges or the previous credits and payments. There would be no difference after it's recorded. However, you should be mindful of something. There are some things that register windows lack. For example, if we record a deposit from customers, we cannot tell QuickBooks Online what items have been given or sold. We also cannot tell QuickBooks Online which invoices to apply the money from the customer to. Take a look what happens if we try. If we come here and we go back to the register window by clicking account, chart of accounts. Now let's take a look again at the register for the cash and bank account. If you say, I would like to record a deposit, notice all they have a field for is the name of the customer and the particular income account that represents the reason why you're making that deposit or getting that money. If you're receiving for a past invoice, there is no place to choose which invoice. If you do it this way, it will simply remain on the books and show up on the open invoice report as a credit until you go and apply the credit the way we learned in a previous video. If it's from a sale receipt, there's no place to choose the service item. You can only choose the income account. And that means on your sales reports, you won't know how many items of video or editing hours were actually sold because you didn't record the hours. You weren't able to. You were only able to record the total income if you recorded it from this particular register window. Now, checks cannot include items sold and cannot be applied to unpaid bills. Well, that's the same idea. If I come here and I say I want to write a check, if this check is for a past bill, there is no field to tell QuickBooks which past unpaid bill is being paid. And if this check is for items that we're buying, there is no field to tell QuickBooks where the items are. So these are the shortcomings of the register window. If you're using the register window, it means you can't be required to record the things I just mentioned. Now, the most important point is that even though you're able to mark a transaction as cleared in the register window, I can't stress strongly enough that you should not do this. You see, this may mess up past reconciliations. However, if you accidentally deleted a cleared transaction that was part of a past reconciliation, you can re-record it and then use the register window to clear it in order to fix the mistake of deleting something that was already cleared. You should double check this with your accountant professional. Now again, I'll be happy to show it to you. What you would do is you would come to the row of an existing transaction, and in this column with the check mark, this column with the check, for example, this one, let's just say you wanted to mark this as cleared because there was some mistake from before. This is the column to click, and it puts the letter C. Then if you save it, it means it will not show up in the bank reconciliation window, or it will show up as marked as cleared if it's a date after the last reconciliation. If it's a date before the last reconciliation, it might not show up in the window at all. So be very careful when marking something as cleared when doing your bank reconciliation, and be mindful of what the registers can and cannot do.